So this is some of the basis of why my rifle builds are as accurate as they are, simply because I'm trying to bring back quality in the manufacturing. The fact that I can control the quality of both the receiver as well as the barrels that I choose to machine really shows the performance downrange. Now, if folks don't know, I actually test every single one of my rifles, including barreled actions downrange, to guarantee the performance. These rifles or barreled actions do not leave my shop laser engraved with my name on it unless they shoot accurate. So these CZ457 rifle builds start off as a brand new rifle. I actually order these CZ457s from distributors like Lipsy's, and I order the Scout model, which is a single shot sled that has the iron sights, you know, pretty much the cheapy version, primarily to collect the action. I had a lot of emails and a lot of requests asking me to rebarrel their CZ457, and the reason why I do not do that, for the simple fact of I cannot provide and guarantee the accuracy due to the variation of measurements that I have seen on the CZ457. So what I'm talking about is there's a lot of CZ457s out there that have different tenon lengths, different headspace lengths, and the reason for it is wear and tear on this area right here. This area right here is actually your bolt lockup for the CZ457, and any kind of wear and tear right here actually causes the bolt itself to fall back further, thus enlarging their headspace. Now, another measurement that I've been actually taking note of is folks CZ457s, the 23 actions that I've actually measured had the inside diameter of these receivers to be tapered. There's not uniform diameter inside, and that causes it to be really hard for me to build a barrel to basically fit exactly how I want to and to have the proper engagement, which I feel is a rigid design for the CZ457. So when I ordered the CZ457s brand new, I have the option of returning the actual rifle itself if it doesn't pass my QC. Now, when I look at these rifles, I'm going to take measurements on the inside diameter on three different spots, starting from the top, middle, and then low. Obviously, turning it 90 degrees, I'm going to see what kind of taper it has inside the ID of the receiver. If I see an excess of over 3 or 4 thou on the taper, this rifle goes back to the manufacturer. If I see headspace measurement to where I cannot build a barrel with a headspace of 42 thou, this rifle goes back to the manufacturer.
How have you decided?
You know, I'll have the linguine, red sauce on the side. If the sauce does not come on the side, I will send it back. I want garlic bread, toasted, not burnt. If it comes burnt, I will send it back.
Okay, then.
So when folks are asking me to rebarrel the CZ457 and guarantee the accuracy, that is the reason why I cannot build a pre-fit barrel. And the companies like Lilja out there and some other pre-fit manufacturers like Area 419, I believe there's Preferred Barrel Blanks making CZ457 pre-fits, though there are some folks getting, you know, good results, I'm not going to go and justify putting my name brand on a rifle build or a pre-fit for somebody to post online on forums or whatnot saying that this pre-fit barrel does not work. So to guarantee the accuracy of my rifle builds, if folks do not know, I hand fit every one of my components and I test every single one of my rifles downrange, and that's the reason why the quality of my work, it supersedes what you can find in the market. So here's the reason why my CZ barrels are really damn accurate. So what I'm doing here is I'm finishing off the tenon. I'm going to be basically thermal fitting this barrel onto the receiver. The receiver that I chose has very minimal taper, very uniform on the actual receiver inside diameter itself. So I'm turning this thing down to have a max tenon length of 1.192, which will give me 42 thousandths on headspace. But that's the chamber side, and I have this thing indicated already chambered up. The outboard side. Now, the basis of my accuracy, like I always tell folks, is my hand-selected barrels. The barrels that I have are as straight as possible. Now, this is a 5/10,000 gauge. I do have a range rod in here, and I'm going to spin this thing. I'm going to show you guys the deflection, or lack of there. So, according to the bore, the curvature of this barrel itself is 1 thou. That's a very, very straight barrel. And my air gauge tool, which I'll show eventually, just waiting on the okay for that, showed a uniform bore taper. This is a Schillen Select match barrel. It has been taper lapped, and the bore itself was uniformly lapped at a 0.2135 tenth thou, starting at a 2138 thou. So it's like I said, very uniform, very straight. So the basis of why my CZ457s, as well as my 22 rimfire barrels, why they shoot accurate, is the tedious hand fitting work that I do, and also hand selecting the barrels. So I'm gonna finish this up. I'm gonna do the extractor relief cuts, as well as get the headspace correct onto this barrel. And then I'm gonna show you guys the performance downrange. All right, got the chamber side all done. Now got the chamber polished up, the extractor relief cuts, as well as the little feed ramp thing, all completely done. So this is actually 5/10 thou larger than the inside diameter of the receiver. We will be thermal fitting this receiver on there, and I'll showcase how I do that shortly. But for now, we're gonna turn around this barrel and finish up the crown. So like I mentioned, these actions are thermal fitted on. You'll see here when I try to go put this action on that it's gonna go only a little bit. Now this action does have a little bit of a taper, and you can see there that I cannot force that action on there, and it takes quite a bit of force to get it out. So what I'm going to do is heat up the action here with map gas slightly, just to expand the actual action itself. That way it'll slip on over the tenon on this barrel here. All right, this thing is smoking hot, and you can see there it is press fit. That is not going anywhere. Now I won't even move, so that's perfect. All right, couple love taps with a dead blow hammer here, and it is seated flush. So we're gonna go ahead and put the set screws on there. It's gonna be extra added rigidity, but that action is mated onto the barrel. That will not come off unless you really force it off, and that or heat up the action quite a bit. But at this point, it is pretty much permanently set onto the action. You see here, no matter what I do, this thing is not coming off. It is on there. So these set screws I have on here are just added security. These are different set screws. They're a 1/4 inch long M6 set screws, stainless steel as well. So I'm just gonna pretty much hand tighten it on there for now. We will torque these things down to 45 inch pounds. So this CZ457 barreled action is going to be tested using a PDC custom chassis. I plan on doing a review on this chassis very soon. Now the joystick rest is an Extreme Alpha, and as far as the scope, I'm using a Zeiss LRP S3. We will be testing this thing at 50 yards and 100. Alright folks, so even with all of that tedious task that I've done building this rifle with the best parts possible, there's always that chance of this rifle not performing downrange. And the final QC test that I do is obviously tested downrange. Now, I'm not the best shot. I try to eliminate the variables like using this tripod joystick rest from X Tripod Alpha. It's basically an SEB Mini. And it really depends on how well I'll perform today and how much coffee I drank. So we're currently at 50 yards. We're gonna see what kind of performance we have with using SK Rifle Match. And you know, I'm basically not gonna beat around the bush and show you as it is, straight off the lathe, and see what kind of performance we have on the first shots out of this rifle. All right, all on paper. That was the first shot. All right, right next to it. All right, that was the same hole. Man, it's already tack driving. Well, that was the first 5 shots out of this rifle. All right, let's go ahead and lay down some 5 shot groups, some kind of repeatability we have on accuracy. Okay, so I just shot a slew of different types of ammo that I have, different lots, starting from the SK Rifle Match, SK Long Range, as well as Ely Match and Ely 10X. The one good thing about this rifle is that it is not picky at all. It absolutely loves everything you throw at it. That's match grade. So let's go ahead and walk down to the 50 yard mark, see what kind of groups we got. All right, so as you can see, the groups here are pretty damn good, so to say. Now, the one thing, the rifle itself can perform very well. However, the ammunition is also half the battle. So this was all SK. Now, this was the first 5 shots out of the rifle. Now, all of these groups up here are SK rifle match. Now, you can see a couple of those 5 shot groups are flyers here and there, but we got a one holder basically right there, all 5 shots. Now, I switched over to Ely match, and first shot was right here as a fouler, and then the rest of it, all 4 were right in that same hole there. Did another 5 shot group, kind of had a weird little stringing there, and then one holer, you guys can see the group size there, and another 5 shots, another 5 shots, another 5 shots. So that Ely rifle match, you can see it's performing very well, and almost the same performance as the SK. Now switched over to Ely 10X, and the first 5 shots are there. Next 5 are one hole bugger right there. Next 5 I had an outlier, and then the next 5 had another outlier. And then this was a 10 shot group with Ely 10X. So you can see that this rifle is absolutely loving both types of ammo. So the rifle itself, like I said, will be half the battle. You do have to do your due diligence to figure out what type of ammo and what lot number that rifle is going to like. All right, so now we are at 100 yards now, and I do have a little bit of a breeze coming in at my 6, so I'm gonna go ahead and shoot some of this Ely match, see what kind of groups we have at 100. Okay, so here's the groups at 100 yards, and kind of really don't want to judge the accuracy because we had some gust of wind up to 4 or 5 miles an hour. But this was Ely rifle match. That's about MOA, so holding 1 inch there. I went ahead and shot the first 5 actually right here. Had one drop down low, then the other 4 here. And this was all Ely 10X. Now this is 5 shots here, holding 1 inch. Had a little bit of wind gust and moved this group here a little bit left. Shot, let's see, this is 6 shots, 1, 2, 3, 4, yeah, 6 shots here. Had one drop down low and 5 shots there. Now the SK rifle didn't perform well at all, had a lot of vertical striation. Here's 5 here, here's the first 5 here. And then SK long range, same thing, a little bit of vertical striation. So from my experience, Ely ammo does perform better at longer ranges with these longer barrels. And this does hold true out to 200 plus yards. So there's the groups at 100 yards with the rifle. Again, not the best groups I've seen, but it is holding sub 1 inch, even in the wind conditions that we have right now. Okay, so we got this KYL rack at 100 yards. We're gonna give this thing a try. Got a little bit of wind coming right at my 3:30, 4 o'clock position. Feels like 3 or 4 mile per hour gust here and there. So will affect the group size a little bit, but let's see if we can clear this thing. 100 yards, Ely rifle match. Let's give this a go. Okay, that was the first one. There's the second one. It gets smaller now. Ooh, miss. Got the third one. Skim packed that one, so I did hit it. Let's get the last one here. Ooh, just left. Got it. So that cleared the KYL rack, 100 yards with the Ely rifle match. All right, let's try this again with 10 shots here. First one. Third one. All I did skim that one. I did see it move. I don't know why that fourth one keeps getting skim packed. Let's get the last one here. Got it. So clear that in the first go round, but let me get that fourth one. I want to get that thing a solid hit. Of course I'm gonna miss. One more. Got it. So this rifle is definitely accurate enough to compete the top level. 100 yards KYL rack, it's kind of my standard if I could clear one within, you know, two shots on each target, even the quarter inch, then this thing is definitely competitive enough to compete definitely top level. See if I could hit that quarter inch one more time. Oh, that was just under it. Oh, I got one more. Let's see. Let's get that. Let's knock that bad boy out. Boom. So folks, that's the reason why my CZ457 rifle builds, as well as all of my other rifle builds, perform downrange. It really comes down to the components being used, top of the line, best of the best that I could possibly get, as well as proper tooling, like the air gauge tool that I have, sorting out these barrels. With that being said, there's a lot of folks out there that kind of want to drive a Ferrari at Fiat prices, and that's just not feasible. I mean, like I said, the cost of these components are high end, and the performance that you see downrange is priced accordingly with the labor that I perform. And there's not many shops that I know of that actually test their rifles downrange. Like I said, if a rifle leaves my shop with my name on it, it's because I've tested that thing and I know what that thing could shoot. Well folks, let me know what you guys think. Comment below. And I will be working on some tooling for the CZ457. So for you folks out there that are wanting to rebarrel your CZ457, I'm not discluding you. I actually am working on a piece of tool that will actually, kind of like a Remington 700 squaring jig from Dave Manson. It'll run down the actual bolt raceway of the action and also ream out the inner channel to make everything uniformly a certain diameter. So until I have that tool perfected and, you know, priced out how long it takes for me to perform the labor of that, I'm currently only going to be offering the CZ457 as a brand new rifle build or barreled action. So if you guys are interested, look at dpgunworks.com, check out the rifle builder, look at the description below, and I have that thing pretty much updated, you know, as of today with the current lead times. So appreciate you guys watching. Stay tuned, there's always more videos, and I'll catch you guys on the next video.